Take our hymnals, please, and turn to page 98, The First Noel.
Thank you. You be seated a moment. I'd like for my brother Terry to come with me to the microphone. Terry, I got thrilled on that last verse. It said, then entered in those wise men three.
Yes.
Full reverently upon their knee.
Right.
And offered there in his presence their gold and myrrh and frankincense. Noel, Noel. Noel, Noel. Born is the King of Israel. Oh, that blessed my heart.
Amen.
Terry's been reading a book that I purchased some years ago, The Day That Christ Died, written by Jim Bishop. And you read a little part in there about the three wise men. I thought before you led us in prayer, you might describe your thrill with the attitude of those wise men as Jim Bishop saw them and wrote in his sanctified imagination. Would you tell us what Jim wrote?
Well, it really touched me how they were able to discern the meaning of the star and follow it to Bethlehem. But the thing that I shared with my brother today was that the kings made sure that they had their royal robes on before they entered the stable. They were going down into the stable, but they made sure that they were properly dressed with the royal robes. They had their robes on, and when they entered, no matter if their royal robes were on, they went on their knee anyway upon the stable floor, which was not the place that probably most kings would kneel. But these three kings knelt on the floor in their royal robe and couldn't take their eyes off Jesus. Their eyes were upon the baby, and I could see how Mary lifted up the swaddling clothes over his face so that they could really catch the sight.
Oh.
And it really thrilled me when I read how this man, in his, as you said, sanctified imagination.
Yes, sir.
Could get the vision.
Yes, sir.
And see the worship of the three kings, the true
right.
worship of these three wise men. So we're thankful to share it tonight.
Amen.
And they were looking at Jesus. He's our Savior.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, he's
Hallelujah.
King today, and I love him tonight, and
Amen.
I'm thankful for him.
Yes, sir.
I'm thankful that he's ruling today, that he's on the right hand of the Father above, watching over and meeting every need. So thankful that he's with us tonight by his Spirit.
Amen.
Praise
Before
him.
You lead us in prayer, could be that Jerry has something to share with us. He's sort of like one of those three kings himself, and he's trembling. He's just had my heart just a-pounding as I'm going into this service tonight.
Well, Pastor, I was privileged to be with the servant last night at a little fellowship dinner he had, and probably a lot of you know about it. They all sent their love to Sky Depot and your pastors, and I was awful excited because I got the newsletter and I'd heard about this sermon already tonight and the 12th sermon on Wednesday the 12th of December. And we wanted to come on a drive-through last night. And Roger says, Brother, you're not supposed to go. So we come on through tonight, and Pastor Sharon a little bit back there in the choir room. And I don't know what it was, but boy, my heart just going thump, 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 thump. So I'm kind of excited to hear what. I think it just come right on over to me because he said he was really excited.
I am.
So by God's grace, I think we got something in store for us tonight.
Praise the Lord, Jesus.
Lord.
We're trusting Jesus. Let us all stand for prayer. Terry will lead us in prayer.
Our blessed Savior, Jesus, our Lord, we come to Thee with thanksgiving tonight. We thank You for this privilege to once again come before Thee, Jesus. We come not in our own merit, but on the shed blood. But we thank You, Jesus, that You did come and live upon this earth, born in the stable, laid in a manger. And, oh, Jesus, You were so precious to live in obedience to the Father.
Touches my heart.
You spoke every word that God wanted You to speak, God the Father. And, Jesus, You were obedient unto death. You died on the cross for us. And we thank You, Jesus, for shedding that precious blood. We plead that blood upon us tonight and upon this service. We pray, Jesus, that You would be honored in all the songs. We pray, Jesus, that You might be pleased with the words that are spoken tonight. We pray for a fresh anointing upon the speaker of the hour, upon Pastor Jesus. We pray, O God, that You would anoint him afresh tonight. We thank You for the sweet spirit and the wonderful service this morning. But Lord, we're asking and begging afresh that You would send Thy Spirit and anoint tonight. Anoint him in his speaking, O Lord, and in the singing. O Jesus, may it be all to thy glory.
Jesus.
Thank you for our brothers and sisters in the Lord. We thank you that we can return to this sanctuary and feel the love of Jesus. Lord, it's a wonderful thing to sense thy presence and to know that you're with us, O God, and we want to honor thee. We thank you and praise thee tonight.
Amen.
I pray, Jesus, that you'll quicken the bodies here, that you'll quicken the people, the precious ones here. We pray if anybody's in suffering, oh God, that you might let it be relieved. You might take it, Lord. Take it from them. Take any suffering from them. I pray that burdens might be lifted and
Amen.
People might be able to look up to Jesus and worship him as we meet together to honor thee. Thank you for this privilege, Lord. Thank you for these precious people here that meet in this place. I thank you that we feel loved and we can come and love and be loved, Jesus, and exalt thee. We thank you that you are love. God is love. Thank you for that wonderful love tonight. Oh,
Amen.
Sweet Jesus, we love you. You've been so good to us, and we're indebted totally to thee. Anoint us now, I pray, by thy precious Spirit. Oh, Jesus, guide and direct, and we'll thank you for it. In thy name we pray this night. Jesus, we don't want to forget to pray for our president. We just pray for President
Amen.
Carter tonight. Oh, God, we pray for the president, the leaders of our country, the leaders
yes.
of this nation. I pray, Lord, for all men in authority tonight, that they would make the right decisions
yes.
to lead our country. Oh, God, forgive us in this nation that we've turned from thee. And I pray, Lord, for revival, for return unto God. I pray, Lord, that you'll come upon us in this nation
yes.
and help us, Jesus, to honor thee and to exalt thee in the way that we go about each day. Thank you again, Jesus. In thy name we pray, amen.
Amen. Two unusual persons on the podium tonight. One is Don Quixote, and the other is his partner, Sancho. And these two men have something to do with the sermon, and also something to do with the trilogy of songs that Michael Bowers is going to share with us before I share with you on the subject of change. Don Quixote is one of the great works in all of literature, and it's a lot more serious than people think. If a man, as far as literature is concerned, ever tried to change the world, Don Quixote did. In spite of windmills, in spite of misunderstandings, in spite of most everything, he kept his idealism. A musical was written called The Man from La Mancha. And Michael's going to sing three of those songs. One has to do with the man himself. The words are very important. The second has to do with the lady of his dreams. And the last has to do with that which is impossible. And that keys right into my message. So, as Don Quixote keeps his dignified posture and Sancho looks on, Michael will sing. You may. Yes, sir.
I especially wanted to say something before I sang the second song so you could have a little bit more understanding of it. The second song is called Dulcinea. It's the name of the girl of Don Quixote's dreams. But her real name was Aldonza. I'm not sure exactly what the meaning of Aldonza is, but it's not a good meaning. Whereas Dulcinea means a sweet one, and this is what he called her. Aldonza was probably the lowest form of a social type of a person you could think of. She was a barmaid, and she was a harlot, and she was, you know, brass and loud, and just anything you would, the exact opposite of what you would think that a queen and a beautiful lady would be. But Don Quixote doesn't see her that way. He sees her in this with this mind that he has, which there was something wrong with it, obviously, but at the same time he had this idealism that was so high that he lifted her, you know. But I wanted to read these words of another song that I'm not going to sing. It was her song. Wonderful. Called Aldonza.
He heard that my sermon was going to be on change, and he couldn't get away from the words of this wonderful musical. Some things are objectionable in the musical. I don't know if they're in the words, but there's a lot of wonderful things in it. These songs are really good. And he wants to read the words and then present the trilogy to us.
Pastor said that the second song witnessed to him a little while ago. The reason it's meant so much to me is because after I'd been going here just a little while, and even when we were coming here full time, I'd gotten to the place where I felt like it was hopeless. That I couldn't change, that I saw there was so much deceit in my heart that any time I would try to repent, I would just fall back into it again. So I'd stop trying to go to the altar because it didn't seem to do me any good. And the only hope I had was I was somehow able to keep coming to all the services. I didn't quit, you know. So I said, well, if I can come to all the services, if I can't do anything else right, you know, I'll just come to every service here until I die, you know, by God's grace. But since then, God's given me hope, and he's shown me, because I've been faithful, and, you know, because he's faithful, and because he really loved me, that he's able to change me, and he's, you know, I've got the hope now that he can make me what he wants me to be by his grace and mercy. And I identify so much with Aldonza because this is what Aldonza was. She was in such a hopeless state.
Yeah.
And when Don Quixote met her, he gave her these, you know, he gave her this dream, or at least he tried to give her this dream in the way that he saw her. He lifted her up, and she, you know, it was so hard on her. She says in these words right here, let's see. You have shown me the sky, but what good is the sky to a creature who will never do better than crawl? Of all the cruel fellows who badgered and battered me, you are the cruelest of all. Can't you see what your gentle insanities do to me? Rob me of anger and give me despair. Blows and abuse I can take and give back again. Tenderness I cannot bear. So please torture me now with your sweet Dulcineas no more. I'm no one, I'm nothing, I'm only Aldonza the whore. And this was her feeling of herself. But the great part about it is in the end, his persistence in his idealism, in the strange way that it was, changed her and transformed her into the thing that he saw her as.
Right.
and Sancho. Hear me now, thou bleak and unbearable world, thou art base and debauched as can be. And a knight with his banners all bravely unfurled now hurls down his gauntlet to me. I am I, Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha, destroyer of evil am I. I will march to the sound of the trumpets of glory, forever to conquer or die. Hear me, heathens and wizards and serpents of sin, all thy dastardly doings are past. For a holy endeavor is now to begin, and virtue shall triumph at last. I am I, Don Quixote, the Lord of La Mancha. My destiny calls and I go, and the wild winds of fortune will carry me onward, oh, whithersoever they blow, whithersoever they blow, onward to glory I go. Never seen thee or touched thee, but known thee with all of my heart. Half a prayer, half a song, thou hast always been with me, though we have always been apart. Dulcinea, Dulcinea, I see heaven when I see thee, Dulcinea. And now I've found thee, and the world shall know thy glory. Dulcinea, Dulcinea. If I reach out to thee, do not tremble and shrink from the touch of my hand on thy hair. Let my fingers but see, thou art warm and alive, and no phantom to fade in the air. Dulcinea, Dulcinea, I have sought thee, sung thee, dreamed thee, Dulcinea. Now I've found thee, and the world shall know thy glory. Dulcinea, Dulcinea.
Would you have Dulcinea stand, please?
She's singing her out of it. That's what you were doing. I knew it.
Glory to God.
Too weary. unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star. No matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right, without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars still strove with his last ounce of courage.